IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 has a huge number of features to make being a Java developer easier. Firstly, IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 makes it much easier to find and select a JDK for your project. If we don't have a JDK selected for the project, IntelliJ IDEA shows a list of all configured JDKs, a list of other detected JDKs on the computer, and we can download a different one too if we want. For now, let's select JDK 14 for this project. We can see IntelliJ IDEA automatically sets everything up to use this version of Java without us needing to do anything else. Since we're using JDK 14, let's take a look at the new features in Java 14. The interesting new features are preview features, so we need to make sure we've selected not only JDK 14, but also the 14 preview language level. The first feature we're going to look at is records. IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 lets us create new Java record classes. Records are data classes with far less boilerplate than we normally have in Java. We can declare a person with ID and name components like this. This class automatically has a constructor, getters, toString, hashcode, and equals. IntelliJ IDEA can generate constructors for record classes. We can generate a canonical constructor, which is the usual Java constructor, and in this case would take an ID and a name. The reason to generate constructors for records is to add functionality, such as validating the field values. If we're only going to do something this simple with our constructor, IntelliJ IDEA will let us know that we can use a compact constructor instead, and we can automatically convert to this. Alternatively, IntelliJ IDEA could have generated a compact constructor straight away if we knew that this is what we needed. IntelliJ IDEA can generate getters for record classes. Note that getters for records don't actually start with the word get, just one more reduction in text. These getters are automatically available without having to create them. Again, the reason we might need them is to do something more than just returning the field value. If we want to change the name of a record component, we should remember to use refactoring to make the changes. This way, not only will all references to the field be renamed, but also the name of the accessor method as well. Then, anywhere that's calling the accessor will automatically be updated to the new name as well. We don't just create new classes from the project window. Often what we want to do is use a new class and get IntelliJ IDEA to create the class for us. IntelliJ IDEA can create record classes as well as standard Java classes. Records can be created in their own file or as an inner record. Another Java 14 preview feature is pattern matching for instance of. IntelliJ IDEA can find places in our code that do instance of checks followed by a cast and replace it with code that uses the new pattern matching syntax. Of course, refactoring works as we'd expect on the pattern variable. We can do other refactorings, like inline the pattern variable to see what the code might look like without the pattern variable. If we extract a variable from the cast like this, IntelliJ IDEA will automatically use pattern matching for instance of and create the pattern variable. On the topic of refactoring, IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 has updated method refactoring to make it even easier to change methods. Normally, we can rename a method with Shift and F6, and this renames all the places the name is used. In IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1, we can just change the name of the method, and a gutter icon will appear asking if we want to rename all usages to the new name. Alternatively, we can use Alt and Enter, and we can rename all the uses from here. This doesn't just apply to method names. It also works if we change the order of the method parameters. Pressing Alt and Enter gives us the option to make the change. Then we see a preview of the signature change. When we accept these changes, everywhere that calls the method will also be changed. We can also add parameters to a method, and the gutter icon will tell us there are refactoring options. Alt and Enter suggests updating the usages and shows the preview, and we can enter a default value for the new parameter. All the places that call this method will then use this default value. This new way of refactoring isn't just for methods, it also works for classes too. Remember to look out for the refactoring gutter icon when you make changes to your code. Now the IDE can preview intentions. For example, if we press Alt and Enter here, select Split into Declaration and Assignment, and press Alt and Space, we can see a preview of what this will look like so we can decide whether or not to apply this change. IntelliJ IDEA offers a quick definition so we can see at a glance what the symbol's definition looks like. In this case, what the method new method name looks like. Now, IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 offers quick type definition, which in this case shows the definition of the type returned from the method, which is object. If we changed the return type to something else, quick type definition would show us the definition of the new type, in this case string. There's no keyboard shortcut for this yet, so we can use Command-Shift-A or Control-Shift-A to use Find Action, or we can go to View, Quick Type Definition. There's a new mode for displaying java.comments, which we can turn on in the Preferences under Editor, General, Appearance, by ticking Render Documentation Comments in Place. If we've done this, we see java.comments rendered in an easily readable format, including links and pre-formatted code. If we want to see or edit the original java.comment, we can click on the icon in the gutter to toggle it back to the comment. It's also possible to change the size of the rendered comments by right-clicking, selecting Adjust Font Size, and moving the slider up or down. This is the same setting that's used for quick documentation, so be aware that changing the setting for one changes it for the other. IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 now uses the power of data flow analysis in the debugger while the program is running. We still have the standard comment style annotation of current variable values, but now the IDE also annotates sections of code where it knows or can predict certain things. For example, in this application, the value of the variable output is currently 1, which we can see from the code but also from the comment the debugger has put on line 17. Despite the fact that the program is still only on 9.19, data flow analysis can be used to see the output variable will be incremented on line 20, and therefore the check at line 22 will be true, as output will have a value of 2 by then. On the next run, with a different input value, data flow analysis shows us that line 22 will evaluate to false this time. Data flow analysis can also pre-warn us about exceptions before they happen, like here, where the name variable is null, and so line 37 will throw a null pointer exception. It can also warn us when particular methods will fail based on current or predicted values. If we want to turn off data flow analysis during debugging, we have to go to the Java section of the debugger settings and turn off Predict Future Condition Values Analyzing Data Flow. As usual, there are improvements for working with version control in this IntelliJ IDEA release. The interactive rebase feature has been improved to provide a truly interactive experience. If, under the Log tab of the Git window, we right-click on a commit and select Interactively Rebase from here, we're shown a dialog with a list of commits we can rebase, with the oldest at the top. We can use this dialog to reorder the commits, to squash commits, to rename commits, and to fix up or drop commits. We can pause on a particular commit if we want to make more changes at this point of the rebase. When we press Start Rebasing, IntelliJ IDEA will apply the changes in order. Here, the IDE has paused in the middle of the rebase like we wanted it to, so we could make more changes at this point if we want. At the end of the rebase, we should see the commit history has been rewritten in the way we wanted. You may have noticed another change in the version control window. If you're using Git, you'll see this is now called the Git window. There are other changes that you probably won't see if you're an existing user of IntelliJ IDEA. Normally, the Command-K or Control-K shortcut brings up the commit dialog so we can commit our changes. If we want, we can use the new commit behavior, which new users will see in IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1. We can turn this on in version control commit dialog by ticking commit from local changes without showing the commit dialog, which applies to Git and Mercurial projects. If we have the setting turned on, when we press Command-K or Control-K, we'll see the new Local Changes tool window with the changed files and the description. You'll also see the Git tool window no longer has the Local Changes tab. We can commit as usual and go back to coding. Note that using this new workflow, Command-9 or Alt-9 will open this commit window, and you'll need to use Command-Shift-9 or Alt-Shift-9 to open the Git window. We need to remember this if we're in the habit of using the Git log. IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate has improvements for working with Spring projects. For example, we can see the endpoint mappings of a running application and make an HTTP request to these endpoints. We can also open the request in an editor so we can edit the request and run it. There's also better support for Spring profiles. IntelliJ IDEA no longer treats profiles as simple strings, which means we can do things like refactor a profile name and have all the places that refer to this name changed as well. It also means we can have code completion for profile names. This makes our lives easier and helps to reduce typing errors in our code. One final new feature is Light Edit Mode, the ability to use IntelliJ IDEA to open a single file in the editor without having to load an entire project. This is still a work in progress, and we can expect to see this feature evolve and improve over time. That was just some of the new features in IntelliJ IDEA 2020.1 that might be useful for Java developers. Thanks for watching.